Yeah, second half. What was the game plan to limit St. Francis on the three-pointers?
I thought they made a lot of tough shots. I thought we were right there, contested them. They just they drilled and they were shooting 60% in the first 10 minutes. So the percentages started to even out as the game went on. But we just discussed with them their five out and where we were getting caught. And, you know, we were switching and we were getting stuck in the hole, which is what we call health defense. So we just played no switch anymore and we really locked them up and saw some really good transition. This is a team that just knocked off Sacred Heart on the home court. And when you only have one day to prepare, it's tough. You know, we played Saturday, we had one day yesterday, and shoot around today. This is a team that does a lot of different things offensively, and they have a lot of action in their sets. So just, you know, the time in terms to prepare and get the team ready, I think was evident just a little bit. But we settled in right after halftime. They made the changes without switching, and we came out and really made it an exciting game in terms of defense and some good transition offense.
Late in the game, you guys were up, you know, 20, 24 points, and you still had that drive from the bench and the, you know, the excitement and just as you would in a three-point game. What does that mean for your team to be able to keep on going?
It's a team, and they pull for each other, and they want each other to be really successful, and they were just happy that the group that was in was getting the job done on the defensive end and the offensive end. And, you know, we're not taking the foot off the gas pedal regardless of time and score of the game. There's an opportunity for us always to get better, and I like the enthusiasm that the teammates definitely showed for the players that were out there.
And you talk about there being, you know, a different player stepping up every night, but Jasmine now with 8 games in double figure consecutive, how big is that after her slow start to be where she is?
Just really nice that the game's just coming easier to her, that she's out there and she's just catching and making shots. It's just, you know, we know just maybe with the slow start, that she would come on, and she's just doing what she does very well, and she's really breaking teams' backs right now. So we want to continue her good play, and I know she wants to as well. It's just a nice team to be around to get better. We got a lot of improving to do, believe it or not. I was excited about how we performed off the backboards. That's really been a shortcoming, the rebounding, but you know the attentiveness and you know how the girls want to win and prepare to win has been impressive. And they have their eyes on a prize, and they're really, really focused on one day at a time getting better in that practice. And you just see that. You've been able to see that in the games, and we want to continue that going forward.
You mentioned rebounding. What else are you looking to work on, even though we're so early in the conference game?
Well, I think it's like, you know, how we're closing out games. I thought that LIU would close out as well. We stayed with a continuity set. Should be calling some more plays and just really examining all our percentages and all our plays where we're having a lot of success. In what plays and where we need to improve in other plays. So it's just breaking down all the numbers and sifting through every piece of edit and film and programs, what we're doing underneath out of bounds, offensively, defensively, sideline out of bounds, just your whole game plan. So it's really, for us, where we're having success and where we're not as successful. And right now it's just been, you know, where we're going to close teams out and whether it's tight or it's, you know, getting, you know, we have a commanding lead to be better, to be more efficient.
I'm having a blast down here. Back up to you. Peace.
Hey, Quinnipiac Bobcat fans. This is Billy Mecca from the Bobcat Sports Network. Please join us this season at the TD Bank Sports Center for some excellent men's and women's basketball and ice hockey games. The TD Bank Sports Center is the best facility in college athletics as it features family-friendly seating, prices, dates, and times. Please call area code 203-582-3905. Or visit QuinnipiacBobcats.com to order your tickets now. Go Bobcats. Peace.